Now, for learning English, first we have to learn grammar. And I will teach you the topic subject and predicate today for class 4 and 5. So, let's begin, children. Our today's topic is subject and predicate. Look at the pictures here and read the following sentences. First picture, this is a girl. Meena goes to school. Second picture, the flower smells sweet. Third, birds are flying in the sky. Fourth, Sam is drinking tea. So look at here, children. In sentence 1, we say something about Meena, that is a girl. In sentence 2, we say something about the flower, here, the which lady holds in her hand. Third, we say something about birds. Here it is flying in the sky. In fourth, we say something about Sam, which is a boy. Okay, children? Now, these are the persons whom we are talking about. So, in a sentence, the person or thing we talk about is called the subject of the sentence. Meena, flower, birds and Sam are subjects of the sentences. The subject is the doer, the action, doer of the action, and it is a noun. So children, these persons are doing something here and we are talking about these things, these persons. So these are subjects of the sentence. Every sentence has two parts. One is subject and second is predicate. So these are the subjects here. Meena, flower, birds and Sam are subjects of the sentences. The subject is the doer of the action. It is a noun. Again in sentence 1, we say something about the subject Meena, that she goes to school. And in sentence 2, we say something about the subject, the flower. Means that it smells sweet. Flower smells sweet. In sentence 3, we say something about the subject birds, that they are flying in the sky. Birds are flying. We are talking about the birds. In sentence 4, we say something about the subject, Sam. There is a boy, he is drinking tea. We are talking about these things. Now, in the sentence, what is said about the subject? These four subjects. What we are talking about the subject is called the predicate of the sub-sentence. Like that, in one, Meena goes to school is the Now, Meena is a subject and the rest part of the sentence is a predicate. In sentence 2, flower is the subject and rest part of the sentence, smell sweet, is the predicate. Like that in sentence 3, birds are subject and the rest part are flying in the sky is the predicate. And in like that sentence 4, Sam is a boy, Sam, we are talking about Sam. So, Sam is a subject and the rest part of the sentence, what the Sam is doing? He is drinking tea. So, is drinking tea is the predicate of the sentence. Thus, predicate is the same part of the sentence. The subject and predicate of a sentence make the idea complete. Thus, every sentence has two parts, the subject and the predicate. So, this is the general information about subject and predicate. Now, here is a table. The following sentences are divided into subject and predicate. Study them carefully. These are the 10 sentences, students. First, the postman brings letter. And here are two columns. First is subject. The second is predicate. So, which part goes in subject and the rest part is goes in predicate? It is clearly showing here. So, look at this here, children, for your better understanding. The postman brings letters. First, the subject, the postman, and the rest part brings letter. It is predicate. Amar flies a kite. Amar is a subject and next part, fly is a kite, is a predicate. Swimming is a good exercise. Third number. So, tell me the students, what will goes in the subject? Swimming, because we are talking about swimming. And the rest part is a good exercise will go in a predicate. Fourth, Pandit Nehru was a great leader. So here it is our noun, Pandit Nehru. We are talking about noun, Pandit Nehru. So it is a subject of the sentence, Pandit Nehru. Look at here. And the rest part, what we talking about Pandit Nehru was a great leader. It will go in predicate. Fifth sentence, reading is a good hobby. So what we are talking about? We are talking about reading. Reading will goes in subject. Is a good hobby will goes in predicate. Sixth, the wind is blowing. So we are talking about the wind. So the wind will goes in subject and is blowing will goes in predicate. Seven, the teacher is going to the class. So we are talking about the teacher. So the teacher is subject and is going to the class is predicate. A monkey jumps on a tree. We are talking about monkey. The monkey is a subject and jumps on a tree is a predicate. Ninth, you go home. You is here in bracket. This is not compulsory to add in the sentence. We only say go home, but here it is in bracket. So we are talking to you, the person who is standing in front of you. We are talking to him. So here is you. You will go is in subject and go home is go will go in predicate. Again, tenth, you take this ring. So you will goes in subject and take this ring will go in predicate. So these are the 10 sentences which will make you understand what is subject and what is a predicate part of sentences. Now, your homework is today choose any 5 sentence and classify the sentence into 2 parts, subject and predicate on your own. If there is any problem, you can write comment in a comment box. I will guide you and I will give you instructions there. If there is any problem, any question, you can write in the comment box. Thank you, children.